Hey guys, it's Saru, and this has been something that a lot of players have been asking for a long, long fucking time. And well, I thought, hey Saru, you have no life, and you you have time, so let's go ahead and get this done. And well, of course, a week later, I had already forgotten and finally remembered yesterday. Oh lord, my life is depressing. So players around, let us gather as I tell you the tale of how to get ambush gear, materials, and how to awaken it, and yes. So firstly, go to your crafting and go to the item that you'll be making. So you have different options. You have weapon, armor, and all that jazz, whatever. So in this case, we'll go with the robe that I'll make for this video. You can see the materials on the right side and everything you need to craft this, otherwise you will not be able to make it. You also need the design itself to actually make it, but we'll talk about that afterwards. And it's different for every design in terms of where it's going on your body part. I will state that you can get the designs and materials from any 417 or 422 dungeons currently. Handkerchiefs are a guaranteed drop in Ruinous Manor hard mode, but sometimes PvP events also included if you win. So that's something for you guys to consider. As well, you can buy them with killing spring points. I believe it's 2 a week. It could be 1 a week. I don't know, I don't really go that route. So let's make the robe and we'll see how it looks. We get a lot of options here, but let's get it to plus 12 quickly. So it's the same thing, going to plus 9, nothing really changes. At plus 9, you'll need to master it in order to go to plus 12. And I recommend you guys not using any spellbind until after you masterwork. Now a cool idea that I used to do is masterwork at level 1 or level 0 or whatever, and then go ahead and just get it to plus 12. But there's not really a big difference. But do not use spellbind. I know a lot of players have been asking me on Twitter or on YouTube. Comments or just message me on Facebook for some odd reason, and like I said, it'll just be a waste and you'll end up wasting gold at the end of the day. Now sometimes it won't masterwork and people have been asking if maybe it's a glitch or something, and it's not that. You don't necessarily have to worry about that, just keep trying and trying. It's the enchant reset and just keep trying. It might cost you thousands of gold to get the identification scrolls and maybe use the master enigmatic scrolls, but it's going to keep doing it until you at least masterwork. And finally getting it to plus 12. The only way to get any gear to plus 12 is to masterwork it, and yes, it could fail a few times and it's gonna cost quite a bit sometimes, so just be prepared for it. Lastly, if you want to further enchant it to plus 15, which is the max, you need to awaken it. And the only available things that you can actually get to plus 15 on this current patch at least are ambush gear and imperator gear. Now you don't want to go with imperator gear unless you really want to waste your gold, but that's all up to you. So to awaken it, it's similar to what masterworking is, where it allows you to go to a further step. When you go to enchant it once more, once you're plus 12, it'll allow you to awaken it, which will cost 2,000 tier 11 feedstock and 1,000 masterwork alchahest. Well, alternatively, you can use 850 extensive alchahest or 600 premium alchahest. It really, I guess it's up to you. Doesn't make much of a difference. Awakening is 100% success rate, so it's not like you're gonna fail, but it is quite costly, so don't worry about that. Just worry about your poor, poor materials. After that, once you're awakened, you'll see that to further enchant to the maximum, for example, to plus 15, it's not the same where you choose the amount of feedstock you want to use. So, for example, for the boots and gloves, you'll need 150 of each, and for the weapon you'll need 200 of each to get to plus 13, 14, and 15. Of course, for the chest you'll need 180. However, it'll cost less if you use extensive and premium alchahest, so I will state that. However, make sure to know one thing, and it's the fact that the different alchahests won't necessarily give you a higher chance to enchant like they did to plus 12. There is absolutely no advantage to it, but it does help with lowering costs. But yeah, that's basically how you craft, enchant, and awaken an ambush piece. If you're wondering where to get it all, like the designs, the materials, and all that stuff. First of all, before you do any crafting, you need to get your ambush design for your particular class through any 417 dungeon or Ruinous Manor hard mode. One thing that I will state that a lot of players don't know is that you can really craft any weapon if you really wanted to, or any piece, and once you get it to plus 15, you can liberate it using a scroll that's available in the cash shop, or you can find it on the trade broker, and you can put that entire piece on the trade broker. So that's something that maybe some people might be interested in. I know a lot of players have been doing that lately, so just in case you didn't know. Anyways guys, I hope that helped. Might be a little too late, and I quite frankly, it's all Gucci, but I thought I'd at least try and help those that may not possibly know anyways, but I hope this does help. Make sure to subscribe and click that adorable little motherfucking bell if you like the video. Comment below if you have any questions or if you just want to chat, and share the video around and help other players, and as always, till next time friends.